stop your crying, it will be alright. Just take my hand, hold it tight. I will protect you from all around you. I will be here, don't you cry.
Good morning and welcome to The Reporter. I'm Holly Gersh.
And I'm Lauren Martin. That song you just heard was You'll Be in My Heart by Phil Collins.
Even though the seniors are at their senior picnic now, I guess that song gets sent out telepathically through radio vibes or something like that.
And they had their last fling this weekend, the senior ball.
They had a great time. With the new regents requirements of New York State, optimists hoped that it wouldn't affect the Guilderland 11X program and its curriculum. However, as the 2000-2001 school year approaches in the fall, the guidance department has already seen a drop in the 11X enrollment. Jen Salisbury and Amanda Conover reports on the advantages of the X program and clears up any rumors that may be circulating.
Kate? As the year comes to a close and the schedules are being set, one course to consider is the integrated program. What makes this course so unique, so different from the traditional English and global studies?
The 9X programs, they work good together because they complement one another. So the students will read a book in English and it'll relate to the history material.
Two teachers in the room, and I think that it's nice for students to look at how the adults interact and how we work together, and it's much more discussion-oriented.
I don't know how often students have been in a course where they've been in a great discussion or they want to go after something and pursue it, and the teacher said, well, we have to get back on task. This is interesting, but we have to get back on task. Well, we don't have to do that in the 11X, and we don't do that because those things that people feel passionate about at that time are the things that you should pursue in great depth, and those are the things that are really learned and remembered.
They become much more precise in expressing themselves and understanding what they believe to be true, which I really like. I think that's a huge advantage in the course.
Meeting every day is a real advantage. I think we have a better chance of building a classroom community, at least a better opportunity to do that.
Well, I think I really love teaching this course. It's really wonderful when you have a partner that you can work with really well, and Ron has been teaching a long time, so he's really mentored me in a lot of things that I'm really grateful for. So that's one thing, and working with the students, it's so different.
There's never been a day where I've said when 11X class is coming along, I really don't want to, I would rather not go to the class. I always want to go. And, you know, the things that make that up, that make that so, are the students. And just, I don't know, the excitement of the class.
This has been a great class because I get to see Guilderland students at their best doing, wonderful project after wonderful project.
If this course is so praised, then why have there been rumors that they're being cut?
Well, actually, there will be less integrated courses next year than there are this year, but it is not because of a budget cutback. Simply put, we have less students enrolling in the integrated courses than we've had in previous years. And since we have added AP U.S. History and AP European History, AP European being in the sophomore year and AP U.S. History being in the junior year, that has drawn a lot of students off so that the integrated program is not as big as it might have been 3 or 4 years ago.
This program will continue to be available for students 9th through 11th grade, so don't discourage yourself from enrolling in the course. For the GHS Reporter, this has been Amanda Conover and Jen Salisbury.
Even though this is our last show of the year, that doesn't mean we don't make mistakes, so we have to apologize.
Yeah, we just tagged Miss Fiorello as Mr. We all know that's not right, but we apologize for
it. Not only is the show unique because of that, but also at the end of the year, we have a new reporter doing one of his first stories.
Yes, Travis Studrick just joined us, and he'll be here full-time next year. After all the rejoicing and partying to celebrate another year's end, the summer will officially begin. What are Guilderland students and teachers planning to do with their summer vacations? Travis Diedrich has the details.
I'm Travis Diedrich, and I'm new at the GHS Reporter. So if you see me shaking, that's because I'm new, and I'm a little nervous. And what we're going to do today is get a survey on what people are going to do on their summer break. What are you going to do this summer?
After I go on vacation with my family to Cape Cod, I'll be influencing the youth of today by teaching summer school.
I gotta go to summer school. I will also be doing some work this summer.
Hard work?
No.
What kind of work will you be doing this summer?
I have no idea, to tell you the truth. I really don't know.
I'm probably going to work a lot of hours at, like, 10 jobs or something.
What's up?
What's up?
What's up? All right, so, hi. So what am I going to do this summer? I'm going to stay out of trouble. Yes, for the first, yeah.
That's a good idea.
I'm still debating my options. This is my first year being retired, my first summer being retired, so I'm really not sure. I think I'll just kick back, inflate the pool, float, enjoy the sun.
I'm going surfing, man!
I'm going on vacation, and then I'll probably just hang out the rest of the summer.
Where are you going on vacation?
Virginia Beach.
Virginia Beach. You gonna have fun?
Yeah.
You gonna go swimming?
Probably, yeah.
You gonna go fishing?
No, I don't like fishing.
You gonna go surfing?
Yeah, probably.
Cool.
I'm in a show, actually, at Towers in the Park, West Side Story, in early July.
I'm moving back to Virginia.
As we look back on the year, all that's left is memories. Hopefully the stories of joy, sadness, disappointment, excitement, accomplishment, and success will live on. Pete Busa put together this end-of-the-year video to help spark some of those memories and bring a little closure to the year.
It's the Guilderland way. It's a part of our culture.
Good morning, welcome to the quarter. I'm Holly Gibb.
And I'm Kate Armitage.
Will you remember me?
That
song.
That
song. Don't let your love pass you by.
Hi, I'm Scott Busa, and today we take you to the Guilderland Animal Shelter, where many animals are in need of your help to find a good home.
Hi, I'm Scott Busa, and I'm here for Modern, which is a Democratic headquarters this evening. We are here.
Construction here at the high school still continues, but the text and improvements, the parking lot right here where I'm standing, just the open
field. December 3rd, there's no snow on the ground, a few flurries, but nothing has accumulated.
And my turkey, and my golly too. For all the turkeys.
So use your hands,
but don't counters as a fundraiser. But what exactly are you fundraising for? Attention all students and staff. Today is Scott Mason's 18th birthday. That's right, you heard it here first.
Oh, I used to go dancing down in the crowd. I'm giving away my age. I was dancing in the doing both.
Today's a D-Day. Have a great day. Today's a D-Day. Well, that little media video just made me cry, but that's okay.
It's all right. Well, Holly, as a graduating senior and with all your wisdom, do you have any advice for us?
Not much advice. Just make sure you guys all have fun, and procrastination is never good.
Well, the seniors will definitely be missed around here. Definitely.
Bye, everyone.
See you next year.